Hey, hey, hey! Hey, 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 man, we got an EZGO here. Whenever you floor it, it quits running. Let me show you how to, let's show you what it is. All right, try to put it forward. Hit the gas, and I floor it. All right, now you see it running now. Now, let's stop first. Now floor it real fast. All right, do it again. I let it stop. But the problem we're having is when you floor it, it cuts off and quits running. It should be on the white, on the black wire, black lead on main negative. We're checking the its. I got my test lead in there. When you floor it, it should go about 2.9. All right, floor it. All right, 3.2. Do it again. Hold us here. Now what we're going to do now, I'm going to look inside this plug here. I checked the voltage here earlier to see what it was doing. All right, floor it.
There it goes.
All right, it quit running. All right, let's see. All right, now we're going to check with the voltmeter. All right, floor it again. You can, hold on, let go. Floor. There we're at 3.3, let go. Barely go with it. Let go. I tell you, when it stops, floor it again. Now you can, all right, you can see there now, it goes at 3.3 and then it quit and then started running. So what that means is that the its is over revving. So now what we're going to do, we're going to show you how to get to the its. On that side there, you have,
I'm gonna let it down.
That's you have 5/16. But like I said, being a limo, it's a pain in the butt. Make sure the key's off, you got it neutral. So I'm going to take it, do now, just cut that get a razor blade. Now this is your its here. You got your black and your white. Your black wire comes in, reads your white wire comes in, reads 14 volts. Out 0.9 to 2.9. So you got 14 and then you got 2.9 at full pedal. 14 in, 2.9 out. And the way it does, the magnetized rod in there, the throttle rod, goes through there. As it goes through there, it compresses the magnetic field and gets tighter. When it gets tighter, that's what produces the speed. It puts out more voltage. Being that there's a plate over this, we're going to take this here and just cut the mat out because it's got a plate. Because normally on a limo, this is two pieces anyway. We're going to cut this here. I guarantee what happened is whoever did this, they put the piece that was cut at the back.
You know it is.
All right, you pull that up. See if the throttle plate, see if it's at the back here. Might be on the back of the limo. Now here, we're going to pull the throttle up. We'll pull this up here. And that's going to be our throttle. We're going to see exactly what's going on with it. Right there. No, it must be out there. No, it's up there then. All right, so it's got to be up here. This is your throttle box here. You can see you got your edge, you got four screws, you actually got two screws in it. Now if you have an older style EZGO, you're gonna have four screws in this. This has got two screws. Phillips head screws. And then your edge is held in by a 3/8 little push nut. Well, let me phrase that, it's supposed to be. You take your screwdriver, it's probably like that in there, both sides. Until you get it open.
And this car is on the beach.
Yeah. So. And you can see here, this is your it's here. One female in there. That there wasn't even plugged in there. That there was barely hanging on. Mm-hmm. All right, so you can see you got your push nut there. There and there. Let me get a 3/8 socket. All right, I'm gonna take this here. Take my socket here, pull this up. Now, when you put this back on, remember it ain't have a plastic tabs. So go ahead, you strip over tight and easy.
That's the motherfucker used to be for the headlights.
Yep. Now, one of the things you want to look at, man, because this is what causes bad controllers and everything, is it cracks between the bolts, between the studs there, between the spades. But damn sure stinks, though.
She's burnt.
I'm going to take this in here and put this on here.
New one looks.
Yeah, you can see the new one there.
Don't look like that. Oh, it smells.
Oh, yeah, you can smell it. It's burnt. It might be burnt internal. You can smell it, can't you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I guarantee it come from them riding it on the beach.
Oh, man. Look at the frame there. All right, plug them back in. Push on good, make sure they're good and tight.
Guys, remember to call that number, $35. Get your golf cart fixed.
843-595-1611. All right, too much. I appreciate all y'all watching and subscribing. But still, in the day, ask a question under any video. I answer every question that is answered by anybody. All right. That's the most work he's done all week right there. That's good, Travis. Now he's probably gonna take a break, 3-hour lunch.
Yeah.
Ready? Yep. Floor. Good gas. What it does?
Is it neutral? Put it forward or reverse?
Don't matter. Forward. Now let's see what voltage. Let's see what voltage shows now. Now you can say, look at the voltage. Even the voltage right now, 3 points. That's about right. All right. Let go. Let's stop. Like I said, black lead on the main negative, red lead inside the black wire. And go ahead. And you can see, look at that, even the voltage is where it should be, 3 volts. It should be 2.9, 3 volts. But if you go down, if you break the range down, hit it again. See, if you break the range down, you're looking at about 3 volts. All right, that's good. The other time it was hitting 3.3 sometimes, 3.3, 3.5. Yep, there we go, man. You seen it. That's what caused the car to go bad, the controller to go bad. That's what caused it if you floored it and cuts off. You seen it here, man. Stay tuned. We'll post some more, man. Hey.